Hello friends, welcome to Pioneer of Success. We are continuing with the citation series, and in this video we'll talk about how to use EndNote and how to tackle different reference style using EndNote. So this is the preliminary video, and we'll be talking more about the fundamental aspects of EndNote, and in the upcoming videos we'll be digging into EndNote and we'll be knowing how we can use EndNote efficiently to do our referencing. So let's start the video with a particular paper. Suppose this is the prep paper. I want to download the citation from the Google Scholar, because I have already mentioned in the previous class, Google Scholar is a website where you can simply download the citation without any hassle. So again, I am showing you this. Suppose this is the name of the paper, we just copy the title. You can also copy the DOI or some other identification mark. We go to Google Scholar, paste the name of the paper, search here, and I have already told you will be getting an option citation here, cite actually. You click on that, there will be an option EndNote. If you click on this EndNote, one file will be downloaded. This is the ENW file, and if I click on it, then if EndNote is already installed in your computer, it will open this EndNote file, and it will be opened in the previously saved EndNote file. So I have already saved a EndNote file for my work, and that's why this has opened. If you want to open a new EndNote file, then you have to go to new, you go to file, then click on new, then you can say I put something, some name you put, say YouTube video, for reference YouTube video, I just save it. So this is a new EndNote file. Now what you have to do, you have to say download this. I already downloaded, I again downloaded. So if you now click on this EndNote file, it will be open in the new EndNote file. The name of this new EndNote file, I have named it as YouTube video, and in the last day also I have talked about different aspects of this EndNote file. So those are the names of the authors, this is the year of publication, title of the paper. Sometimes this journal name goes mistakenly goes to this place. You have to be careful, just Control V and Control C and Control V and remove it from the name of the author. So you have to be very sure, very careful about this. Now you just check it once. Those are the names of the authors, name of the paper, journal name, volume, issue, number of pages. I have already mentioned this means then this to this in an issue there are multiple pages, and what are the page numbers for this particular paper, that is given here. There are other options as well. Suppose you want to put this PDF file of the paper here, then there is one option attach PDF. You can download the PDF and you can attach it. So let me just show you. Suppose I want to download this paper, I go to the PDF file, I download it, say it is going to my downloads folder, I have downloaded. Now I go to the EndNote file, I click on the option attachment, this is the paper, I click on it. Now you see the paper has come. So what you are trying to make actually, you are trying to make a directory where you will be putting all the references you are going to put in your manuscript. So put all the references one by one. Against this reference, you can just attach your PDF file. Suppose this EndNote file later on, you give it to somebody else, and the person clicks on here and goes to the attachment, he can just see what is the paper. Okay, just for a look, you can have it, but it doesn't matter. Even if you don't attach this paper, it doesn't matter as far as referencing is concerned. But as I am discussing about the fundamental aspects, I am telling you this. Okay, and this is preview. Preview means you can understand from the name itself how this will look you if you put it as a citation that is showing. So you see initially name of the authors will come. This number is their reference number. Then this name of the paper will come. Then year, volume, issue, and the page number. Now this is a particular style for different journal. The styles are different. Now first thing is let us put it somewhere in a doc file, because we'll be writing our manuscript. So this is the manuscript file, and I am writing something, say gold nanoparticle synthesis. Say in this place I want to put the reference. So what I do, just put the cursor here, and in the Word document you will have an option of EndNote. If you download and install the EndNote file appropriately, then there will be an add-on in the document file as well. In your Microsoft Word there will be an add-on. You go to this EndNote X9 add-on, there will be options of insert citation. Make sure in the EndNote file you click on it. If you do not click on it, it will not come. Now you go to this Word file, click on insert citations. There are multiple options: insert citation, insert selective citation. Now let me click on insert selected citation. Now which one is my selected citation? This particular one. Now in this entire file we have only one reference. But if you put 50 references, there will be 50 references. So out of 50, if you want to put this particular one, you can do it in two different ways. First way is, which I prefer, you click on the exact citation from here, select it, and then go to the Word file. In the insert citation, click on insert selected citation. Once you click on it, it will come at the bottom. You can write it references. Yeah, so this has come. Now there are different styles. Okay, see, I have mentioned it, ACS applied a material and interfaces. So this is the style. By default it was saved, because might be I have worked with this particular style, that's why it is automatically selected by default. But you can change it from here. There are multiple options. Suppose IEEE, if I click on IEEE, you can see the style has changed. If you click on some other, say Nano Today, this is a different style. So you can choose this many styles, say RSC Advances. Every time you choose, it will change. But where from these styles are coming? To know that, you have to go to C drive. I go to program files, because in this particular folder I have installed it. So when you install it, it will go somewhere depending on the directory where you have saved it or where you have installed it. For my case it is program files, EndNote X9. I click on it. In this in this folder you will be getting multiple files and there's multiple folders. So here there is a folder named styles. You can see it. If you click on it, you can see there are multiple styles already saved. If you have in your EndNote there are by default this many styles. If you do not have the style, what you have to do, suppose there is some journal which has newly come and you have installed your software say 2 years back. Now the journal which has recently come, automatically obviously that style will not be there. Suppose I want to download the EndNote style of ACS energy material. So let me write download EndNote style of ACS energy materials. Okay, just search it. So this will come, ACS energy materials. This is the download style. I click on download style. So this style is downloaded. I go to the file. This is ACS applied material and interfaces only. We have to look for ACS energy material studies. Maybe this option is not available. Let me write something else. Say ACS Omega. Another journal. Yeah, this is Omega Endnote. Let me download this one. If I download it, now copy it, now go to this folder, the style folder, and just paste it. Continue. So you can see ACS Omega has come. Now if I go to this place, I have to change it. I click select another style. So this will come. And ACS Omega is there because I have already stored it. So I change it to ACS Omega. So yeah, after changing, just click on update citations and bibliography. Once you update, so this is the ACS Omega style. That's why might be this is similar to ACS applied materials and interfaces, as both are from ACS. So that's why it's not changing. Again, if you change, suppose biomaterials, I click on biomaterials, it has changed to that particular style. Okay, so this is how you can insert your citations. Suppose I'll download another citation from Google Scholar. Suppose I was looking for Turkevich method. Now I look for something, say micro motor based power generation. Some random search I put. So they say this particular paper, I want to download the citation. I click on EndNote. It has downloaded. Now double click on it. It will go to this particular place. Yeah. Again, some problem is there. That's why the journal name is coming with the author. You have to separate it out. Sometimes it doesn't come because of some installation issue. It may come. But you make sure that everything is in appropriate place, then only your citation will work fine. Now out of this, say this is, there is an author, Joseph Wang. Okay, now I go to all references, and from here suppose I write something and I want to put the reference, say micromotor. After this word micromotor, I want to put this particular reference. So I go to insert citation. Now I have to find it. Okay, say I find it Wang. See, this particular paper has come. So I just click on it. Yeah, you see, this paper has come, the second paper in the citation. So this is how you can put your citation. You can change the reference style, and there is one option, bibliography. If you click here, there are multiple options. From there you can change the font size and font number. Suppose I want to choose font size 12. I want to have Times New Roman. I want to have spacing of 1.5 lines. I just click. So you see, it has become 1.5 spacing. It has become Times New Roman font 12. So from here you can change your style. Not only that, after putting everything, if you select on it, you can simply reformat your case. Suppose I want to justify it, I click on justified, then it has become justified. Now again you can change the spacing. Suppose I put 1.15. so based on your requirement you can change those things, and there are certain more things which we'll be talking in the upcoming classes. So for today we finish our class here. And I request you to subscribe to our channel, because we'll be coming up with all the details which a research scholar needs. And I hope this series will be very much interesting to all of you. With this, I am ending today's video. Thank you very much.